Okay, today we're doing a water pump seal. Now we just take off the pump itself, just unscrews counterclockwise, and there's the seal. That's the seal there. Okay, let's take a, now before we take that out, best thing to do is if you have the new seal.
Right in that bag there.
Okay. It's always best to have the new seal so you can see what the heck you're doing and what you're dealing with. Okay, we got two seals here. This is the water pump seal. Then we got the oil seal, which is sitting right behind it. Okay. Now you see this is all one piece. Here it's kind of tough to tell if you're just looking at it inside the machine. But once you have it in your hand, you can see it's all one solid piece. So basically what we're gonna do is, this part here, we're gonna destroy. We're gonna hack that out. Once we pull that out, it's held in with a spring. Then we're gonna get a screwdriver and we're gonna start banging down. We gotta pry that part out.
That's in there tight, isn't it?
It's very tight, right? So once we pry that out, or kink it down, and somehow we need to pull it through. Once we get that out, then you got the oil seal sitting right behind it.
That's easy to come out?
That should pop out easy. Let's take a look at it. If I remember right, it sits in there like that. Okay. So now one thing what I used to do is, once you take this part off, you have the shell just left over. If you can't pry it out, if you have a tough time, what I'll do is I'll grab a drill and drill 3 or 4 small little holes inside here, so it comes out through the back. And I'll put in a couple screws. So as you're screwing in, the screw is pushing through and putting pressure.
Oh, on the back plate there.
On the back plate.
Yes. Okay.
And then it helps you pull it out.
Makes sense.
If you're having a real tough time.
Makes sense, yeah.
But make sure if you're going to do that, you're going to have to replace this. A lot of guys.
Wasn't that the whole idea, just to replace that? Is that where it's leaking from?
A lot of guys don't replace that, but you're there. Once you get it open, you might as well change it. Change it also. Right?
It's because of leaking because of that rubber seal, right?
Well, it's because of this. It's leaking.
Oh, okay.
Right? Be very.
So you're
careful.
Changing the back one because you're at that spot already.
Okay. That's right. Okay.
Let's get to it.
Let's give it a shot.
Turn it off.
Yeah. There we go. Okay. So first, we're starting off with this part.
Mark, when you say hacking it, you weren't joking.
Let me get a bigger.
So you don't care about damaging anything right there?
Well,
I mean, I shouldn't say anything.
Be gentle on the
shaft.
On the shaft or the frame, right? Just trying to pry it out. But you don't care about destroying the center piece,
you're replacing it anyway.
Replacing it. So.
Sometimes you get lucky.
It does come out. Right out of the
What's bottom. Behind there? Oil?
Yeah.
You can see a little bit of it. That's the engine oil, right?
This is still antifreeze coming out.
Look at that, everything's coming out, Frank.
Yep. Told you, don't worry, you have to destroy this thing.
No, I'm saying everything's coming out.
See, we're getting lucky on this one. So you can see the back of it, the back lip here.
Yeah,
it's coming out a little bit too.
Look at that, eh? How many of these you've done so far?
Done what, half a dozen so far?
And there's not one posted anywhere.
I know.
Hopefully this will be the first and it'll be helpful for you guys.
The first one took me the longest. Well, just because you don't.
You're new at it, right? Cut her up.
Let me try wedging a little bit more stuff. Just go and just try not to make any damage to the.
Yeah, it's only my bike, anyways, Frank. You don't care. It's only my bike.
Threads.
It's been breaking down lately, anyway. So one more time, we'll call it again.
Yeah.
Nick would love this if it breaks down again. He'd sell me his, that no-no machine that he has. Seems like it's freeing up a little bit there.
Yeah. Just gonna fight with it a little bit. Hopefully eventually it comes out.
There we go.
So now we got the inside of the thing in, but we still got the seal. We still got that shell still stuck in there. We still got to take that out.
We just
took out the inside part.
Which is the back part.
Now we got to take this part out. This is the part that gets really tough sometimes. So now here, because it's empty, now we can fold it in. But try not to
damage
the housing. Nice and easy. Behind on your regular bills, getting new payday loans to pay older loans. Don't let this payday cycle ruin your. Boy, let's try to catch a lip on it.
Try to get a little lip there to the.
Yeah, well, like I said, you're trying not to damage the case, right? I couldn't grab it here where it's nice, you can work. I had to get it here.
Whatever it takes. We got some.
Getting a little bit. There we go. A little bit of time. Bend it. Specking. Got a scooter. Get more leverage. That's the other problem. It's just getting leverage. Come up now. Starting to finally get.
Look at that. Look at that. Okay. Now we start. We got bite.
There we go. Well, starting to come. You can get your screwdriver in there and start trying it out.
The initial startup was a little harder, and then once you get it going.
I can use a bigger flashy brush. Get a little more leverage in there.
There we go.
There we go. That's it.
Done.
That's the sucker. That's the probably the hardest part, is getting that part out.
Now behind there, there's a seal.
In here. And then you just clean everything up there. You can take a look. See your oil seal. Now you don't have to change it, but since you're here, that's why I always figure. You might as well take that out, and that should usually pull up pretty easy. I need a little screwdriver, something to hook it in there. Just grab a little.
Oh, there you go.
Because we're gonna change it anyways. That grabs. Here's the drill.
Oh, you got it.
I think
I got it. There we go. That came
just
out.
Enough just to bite it to get it out. Okay, and you can see inside there, I see where your oil goes through. You see the two ports where the oil is. And there's your weep hole. This is the problem that everybody has, to complain about the weep hole.
Hold on.
Let's see, I'm going to have to clean it. Now, just so you can see, there is oil coming out now. Now, a lot of times some guys may just keep the machine on their side, but I always like to change the oil after I do this too. I'll change the antifreeze and the oil. Okay, we can see a little cleaner now. See, can we see the weep hole? It's hard to see. Yeah, there's a tiny, small little hole there.
Yeah. I don't know if the camera can pick it up, but.
But that's that weep hole. What happens is if this seal starts to leak, instead of going into the oil, it comes out of the weep hole and it gives you an indication that, you know, you got a problem. The seal is starting to go. That's why they put the weep hole. Or you'll never notice it. It'll just go straight into the engine.
Oil, yeah. Mix up with the motor oil.
Okay, let's clean this up now.
Trying to clean up the old sealant as much as you can.
I like using WD-40 to clean it. Lubricates and apparently WD-40 is supposed to be good for gaskets too. Helps loosen them up. stickers, gaskets.
Now I know why you want to change the oil after with all that.
Well, like I said, you get contaminants and stuff, and whatever. It's
that's
a good
okay.
time to change the hands. Okay, it's. Since we're here, let's take a look at the weep hole, make sure it's cleaned up. A little tiny hole there. Get a fine needle.
Just to clean it out, just in case it's clogged or something.
Yeah.
There you go.
You see
it's
it
right through, yep. Yep. Okay. There you go.
Now with this weep hole, Can-Am came up with a bulletin to make a change to it. They wanted you to drill and tap that out, and so you can put this hose barb in there.
Oh, I see, okay.
All right. That's a fine threaded there. Then you put the hose barb, I guess they call it, and you have a 1/8 inch hose, and then you bring it up. So this way the stuff gets inside. And that's what ends up happening. There's water, mud gets inside here and starts to rust out. That's why the problem that we've always had with the weep holes, and they go bad. That's what they say, that's the reason why it goes bad.
So because of that new mud, that it lasts even longer?
Well, supposedly, yeah.
So nothing gets in.
Oh, but to do this, like you see, I have the kit here, but you have to friggin' pull out the engine in order to drill the hole at that angle. Because, you know, it's hard to get in there. Or from the backside to drill a hole.
You can see it right there, yeah.
Like, how are you going to drill there?
Jeez.
Right through there with a drill. Just so hard. So a lot of guys don't bother. They'll just change the seal every couple of years and... Once you do it once and...
I mean, it's not bad. It's a 2007. It's like, I mean...
Yeah. Well, you got lucky. You've gone pretty far with it. A lot of guys, sometimes they have to do it within the first year. Okay. Let's put the oil seal back in first. Slides that in.
That's just pop right in. Slide right in?
Yeah. Slides in like that. It's pretty straightforward. Just push it in. I'm just gonna get a small socket so I can get it nice and flush in there.
Yeah, okay, that's right. I'm sorry.
Okay,
go ahead.
Better get a socket. Just can get it nice and flush in there. That looks pretty good there. And just give it a little tap. Put that one too?
No. Make sure it's sitting properly.
Yeah, looks pretty flush all around. Okay, that's good. So we got the new oil seal in. Now we're gonna put the water seal. Okay, so now this one here. This wouldn't hurt to
move it up a bit.
Yeah, I'll put some W-40. Grease, W-40. Just to make it go in a little easier. Okay, now the trick to this is you got to be very careful when you're pushing this in. I'll use a socket like this to get around that. I might have to use, yeah, it's not bad, around that. But when, as you put it in, the shaft is going to hold, make the middle piece pop out. And then don't forget, it's only held by a spring. So what you do is you pop that in a little bit and then turn around and push this in together so you don't overstretch it. And try to put it in as even as you can. Okay, so we started it. So see how the middle is not going too good? So well, make sure you don't pull that in too far. Put it in the middle. They're going together. Put the outside. Put it in the middle. The outside. pretty flush there. Okay, so that looks pretty flush. It looks like it's all the way in. Now you don't want to overdo the middle one either. Okay? You want to just kill the seal too, right? So it's still got a little bit of play. I think that looks pretty good. And that's pretty much it for water pump seal. Now get your pump. Screw back on. That looks good. Be flush. That's it. Close her up. Put your antifreeze in.
Bleed it.
And Bob's your uncle.
And Bob's your uncle.